Hotep. Peace, everyone. My name is Ram Hotep, broadcasting on behalf of 13signsastrology.com. Want to say greetings to everyone that's new to this channel. Basically, what I'm going to be doing is putting out a little bit of information pertaining to the Galactic Federation of Light. But before I do that, I want to just kind of lay a foundation. Now, many of you know in my other videos, and I'm not going to spend too much time on this, that I have broken down God, I've broken down the devil, I've broken down heaven, I've broken down hell. So I'm bringing this up because this video is actually about solutions. It's about solutions. And if you really want a solution to the problems that are going on in the world, predicated upon whether you think it's the Illuminati or the New World Order or a conspiracy or whatever you think it is, alien and extraterrestrial control, at the end of the day, it's about solutions. In order for you to solve the problem, you must first fully understand, understand, and overstand the problem. It's the first thing you must do. You can't solve a problem until you first know what the problem is. And the problem is that many people that are into the whole movement of so-called conspiracy theories and things of this nature, we want to mix up religion and say that that's the solution. Some people want to go march and say that that's the solution. Some people want to go get their guns and say that that's the solution. Well, none of these things are the solution. So that's the first thing I want to point out. Now, as far as religion, I mention religion a lot, and I bring up religion because you have to understand that God, or what you would call perceived as God, is not going to get you out of this situation, because this is an extraterrestrial problem and an alien problem. And God is actually, for one thing, it means to invoke. It means a deity. It means force and power. So when you look at God, you're really looking at basically a title that any being or entity can sit in the seat of and pretend that he or she is that. I want you to really think about that. So when you think about even the Most High, you say, well, I'm just going to pray to the Most High, and the Most High is going to solve my problems. You see, there is no outside entity outside of self that is going to come to save your problems, but there is a group of beings that are interested in the affairs of humanity, and that's what the Galactic Confederation or Federation of Light is. It's a group of beings that are concerned with the affairs of humanity. But here's the catch. Now, when human beings were first created, I've mentioned this in other videos, there was no God that created us in the sense of what you think. Now, there was a God, meaning one who had the power, the knowledge, and the wisdom to create us. There was a God in that sense, and that God was actually a being outside of yourself, which was an extraterrestrial being at the time. And what these beings, it was actually multiple beings, and what these beings did was is that they mixed the genetics of a monkey, of a reptile, and of themselves into, and blended them together into a species, which you would call a human being. And this is how human beings were created. Now, this story can be read in full when you research the stories of the Anunnaki and things of that nature. And even when you really, truly research the Bible, this story will teach you about the beginning, which was the group of beings called the Elohim, which were really the Elohim were a group of extraterrestrial beings. And then Elohim means more than one. So I've went into this information before, but I have to lay a foundation. So when the group of beings that created humanity, when they did this, they did this without the consent, without the approval of the Galactic Federation of Light. They did this, some people call it the council. They went against the council to do this. It was a group of beings. Now, the group of beings that did this were not your disagreeable beings that you hear me speak of in some other videos. These beings were actually agreeable, but the thing is that they went against the council and created humanity, which was totally bogus to the council. So what happened was that they had a karmic debt to pay for this. They had a karmic debt to pay for this. Now, they did this for a reason. It was a reason why, and I'm not going to go into that in this video here. It was a reason why they did this against the council's approval. But the fact of the matter is, to them and their planet and their dimension and where they're from and their galaxy, it was wrong. And they had a karmic debt to pay for that because they created us without the consent of the council. Now, this is why in the Bible you read about in the story of Noah, why this so-called God wanted to flood and kill all of the humans. You have to ask yourself, why did God want to kill all the humans and wipe out all the humans? Is God an exterminator? What was the reason for that? Because the leader of the council at that time was a certain entity and deity, and once he found out and got wind from those group of beings that created us, and like I said, I'm not going to go totally into the story, but I have to say a little bit. Once he got wind of the beings that created us, I mean, once he got wind of what the beings created us, what they did, he was upset. And he decided, he was the leader of the council at that time, he decided that he wanted to basically wipe out humanity, period. And this is what the story of Noah is really talking about. So what happened was that the group of beings that created us, they took interest in us because we were like their children. So it's almost like if somebody says they're going to kill your children, they had an emotional attachment to us because these beings have emotions. We got our emotions from these beings. So they had an emotional attachment. So the group of beings that were rogues, that, well, they weren't actually rogues, but that group of beings that were rebellious that went against the council at the time to create us, these group of beings had an attachment to us. So they basically found out about what the council was going to do and what the emperor or the most high of that council was going to do. So they decided to tell humanity about it, which they told Noah and his family, and they saved a group of humanity from being totally eliminated. So when the flood hit, a group of humans survived, and they taught them how to go into the center of the earth, and then they came back out. Now, I went into this, but I'm laying the foundation for a reason. So basically, the Galactic Confederation decided, okay, we're going to quarantine this planet. You guys created these beings. You guys have got something started. We tried to wipe them out. They're still here. So we're going to go ahead, and what we're going to do now is we're going to quarantine this planet. And basically what a quarantine is that when you have an experiment or anything like a virus or something like that, you quarantine means you isolate it so that no outside germs or no outside chemicals or anything or any outside substances can intervene with your experiment and its growth. So this is an evolutionary planet. So what they did was they wanted us to evolve on our own based on free will. Now, if you watch my video about the reptilians, and I'm sorry, about the Luciferians and the Satanists, you'll understand this. But basically, the Luciferians and the Satanists, it was in their interest because they were here before us. They were cast out and they were put into this planet. Now, this is another group of beings. This is not the beings that created us. It's a group of beings called the Luciferians and the Satanists that were here on this planet before us. And it's recorded in the Bible under when Satan was cast to the earth. Satan was here on this earth before Adam was here. And this is why when Adam was walking in the garden, the snake pops up. And I've talked about that in that video, so you might want to watch that video about Lucifer and Satan to get more information on that. Who is Lucifer and who is Satan, if you haven't already. So these Luciferians were here before us. They were here before us. So when they basically were already here, once the council decided that they weren't going to have anything to do with us and they want us to evolve on our own, they basically left. This group of beings that created us, they had to leave. Because they had a karmic debt to pay on their planet and their dimension and their galaxy based on what they did. So they left this planet, this evolutionary planet called Earth. And there's actually 7 evolutionary planets besides Earth that exist and are evolutionary planets just like ours. What I mean by evolutionary planet, like I said, is we have to work our own karma out here. This is an experiment. This is what we call an experiment in metaphysics. This Earth and this life is an experience because it's an experiment. Experience is an experiment. See, this is how the world really works. So the Galactic Federation decided we had to work out our karma or work out our evolution on our own. So what happened was these group of disagreeable beings, they seen it as an opportunity. See, when the quarantine was set, a quarantine basically isolated this planet from any other group of outside extraterrestrials. It isolated this planet from them being able to help us. So no group of extraterrestrials could come save us. And this is when you get into the solution, you see, because if there is a God, it's the Galactic Federation of Light. What you think of as God and your concept of the Most High or the Creator or God, really not the Creator, but the Most High or God is the Galactic Federation of Light. And I say that because they are the only group of beings that can save you from this situation. But the thing is that you have to in turn really save yourself by breaking free from the control of the reptilians and the Luciferians that control this religion, that control this planet through religion, through sex, through money, and through the miseducation of it. So the Illuminati, they're not the ultimate controllers of this thing. It's a higher group of beings that are extraterrestrials that I spoke of in another video called the Real Illuminati or a group of reptilians. You should watch that video. But in that video, I talked about how the Illuminati are basically getting their technology and their information from another group of extraterrestrials that they made allegiances with. So in order for humanity to get the attention of the Galactic Confederation, they decided for us to, if they want the quarantine lifted, if these humans truly want to break free from the control of these disagreeable beings and they want to make it and get initiated into the Galactic Confederation, that they're going to have to basically show that an interest that they want to break free from these reptilians. But the thing is, the reptilians and the Luciferians are smart. They're brilliant. And what they do is they sit in the seat and act like they're God. So they set up all these dummy religions, all these dummy schools, all these dummy secret societies, and they got you thinking like this is the ultimate power structure, when really it's not. The ultimate power structure, like I said, is a group of ETs that are giving these world rulers all their information. So they get you wrapped up in government and all of these different things, and they don't want you to reach out to the Galactic Confederation. And the only way to reach out to the Galactic Confederation is through a means of building an alliance with them. And I can do a video on exactly how to build an alliance, but I'm not going into that here. What I'm basically going into here is to point out that the Galactic Confederation of Light is the only way to get out of the control of the New World Order and the things of this nature and the problems that all of these different groups of conspiracy theorists, if you want to call it that, or whoever. Like all of us free-thinking people, we have to realize that in order for us to make it through what we're going to make it through, we have to reach out to the Galactic Confederation and get their attention, meaning that enough humans have to want to break free from the reptilian control and the Satanist control and the Luciferian control and the Draconian control. Insect control. We have to want to break free from that. You see, and there's many humans that still are asleep, and that's what the reptilians want. Their survival and existence is based on this. As long as there's enough of us asleep, as long as there is enough of us that continue to operate in this matrix like nothing's going on, then they get to continue to rule this planet, which they've been doing before us. They don't like humans. They don't like humans. The only reason why they use humans for control purposes, for slaves, and to basically keep the grid of the planet under a quarantine, because as long as the quarantine is set up, they can control us. Now, I want to point out this before I close this video out. This group of disagreeable beings, or what you would call malefic beings, are actually a group of rogues. They're a group of rogue beings. See, the beings that are part of the Galactic Confederation, they're a part of a higher structure, a higher council. These beings that are here on this planet, that are posing as gods, that live in the center of the earth that I talked about before, and live in different caverns in the earth, are really what you call a group of rogue beings. And they act like they're gods, and they sit in the seat and act like they're gods, and they don't want you to know how to contact the Galactic Confederation. They don't want you to know that there's people on this planet that have got contact with the Galactic Confederation. Now, the Galactic Confederation is a federation of over 3,000 nations, 3,000 star nations. It's just like the UN. Just like the UN. And basically, it's like how the UN has different nations that are part of it. The Galactic Confederation has different star nations that are part of it. And they exist in the 19th galaxy. This is where the council resides at, in the 19th galaxy. You might not understand that right now, but you will come to understand that, which is in the Sirius star constellation area. So the Galactic Confederation, like I said, is 3,000 star nations. They actually have ships here. They've been trying to contact humans. They have contacted certain humans since 1913. This is when they begin to contact and reach out to humans to seek out those humans that want to break free from the control. But the thing is that they're not seeking us out. They're monitoring us, and they have millions of ships that are basically look like clouds, and they're around the earth as well. And the scientists, NASA and those people know that they're out there, but they won't tell you about them. But there's millions of ships right now circling our earth, and the Galactic Confederate, and they're invisible. And the only way you can see them is if you learn how to tune into your higher self and to raise your vibration to see them. And the reason why you can't see them is because you haven't raised your vibration, because the reptilians are keeping your vibration low. So the Galactic Confederation, they have a supercomputer, and they're monitoring all social networks. They're monitoring YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and they're looking out for those people that do want to break free from the control of this control grid, of what you would call the so-called Illuminati or whatever, and the control of these disagreeable reptilians. They're looking for those people that want to learn how to build an alliance with them. They're looking for those groups, and they have certain people involved in these different networks that they are communicating with, that they give them information, and these people go back and teach the masses this information or whatever, and they're basically like go-tos between the Galactic Confederation and the go-tos between humans and the Galactic Confederation. So if you want to break free from this control, you have to understand that there is a solution, and the solution is the Galactic Confession of Light, and this is the only way that we're going to break free from this control of these Luciferians, these reptilians, these extraterrestrials. And the only way that the quarantine is going to be lifted is if enough of us reach out through building an alliance, which is a certain way you do that, and I can do that in another video if you want me to, but through building an alliance with the Galactic Confederation. I hope this video helped. Thank you for watching. And for more enlightening information, visit my website, 13signsastrology.com. Peace and paradise.